Hi students, now in today's class I am going to introduce the concept of torque. Okay, torque, or it has another name, moment of force. Moment of force. So this torque or moment of force, it is a turning effect of a force. It is turning effect. Turning effect of a force about a fixed point. About a fixed point is called a torque. What is that? It is a turning effect of a force about a fixed point. It is analogous to force. It is analogous to force in translatory motion. In translatory motion, what does force causes? External force causes motion to the in translatory motion. Similarly, the torque causes rotation in translatory motion. This is a torque. Torque causes rotation. Cause to rotate a rigid body about an axis. Torque cause to rotate, cause of rotation to a rigid body. Torque cause to rotate a rigid body about an axis. So how it is measured? Measurement of torque. It is the product of it is the product of force and perpendicular distance of the point of application of the force. It is the product of force and perpendicular distance of the point of application of force from axis of rotation. Okay, from axis of rotation. So it is thus measured. See, this torque is a, we can write it as, suppose you take this one, this example. Let us consider a rod fixed at this point. Okay, so your force is applied at that point. In this direction. Okay, this is the point of application of force. Here it is fixed point. This is a fixed point. Okay, let it be consider this is a uniform. What is this? Is let it be AB. What is AB? a uniform or non-uniform, a rod, a uniform rod. So O, this C is the point of application. C is the point of application where this force is applied. That point is called point of application, C. Now this C, this distance AC, we can call it as position vector R bar. Okay, so this is the position vector R bar. So the angle between position vector and force vector, let it be theta. So what is theta? Angle between position vector and force. Position vector is R bar and force, let it be F. Okay. So because of this force, this rod is fixed at this point, you apply this force in this direction, then this rod has a tendency to rotate. So it causes rotation about this point. So it turns in this direction. Okay? About this A, about the point A. Let it be this axis of rotation, fixed point. So it turns. So because of this force, this rod has a tendency to rotate. Okay? So tendency to rotate, it will rotate about this point. I want a torque. So this torque depends upon force. So you resolve this one into components. This component, let it be F cos theta, and this component, let it be F sin theta. So this torque is, because of this component F cos theta, this component F cos theta, it does not cause any rotation about this point. It does not influence, it does not roll any role for cause of rotation. The only F sin theta causes the rotation. Okay, this component causes rotation for this rod. So this force into perpendicular distance, that is, so this torque is equal to product of force into perpendicular distance we want. So force is F sin theta into perpendicular distance, let it be R. So this can also be written as R bar cross F bar, because R bar cross F bar is F R sin theta, where theta is angle between. This can also be written as F into R sin theta. Okay, we can write like this also. Okay, product of F sin theta into R, or F into R sin theta. This we can write it as tau bar is equal to R bar cross F bar. So this is the formula to calculate torque. This is, you can read it as R bar cross F bar. Okay, so it is a cross product, it is not a cross product of two vectors is a vector quantity. So where torque is a vector quantity, its the direction is, so this is the formula to calculate torque. Okay, or simply we can write it as torque is equal to F into R perpendicular. We can write like this. So F into R perpendicular, that is perpendicular distance. Okay, that is the meaning, force into perpendicular distance. Simply we can define. So what are its units? units is, force is SI unit, force is in newtons, distance is in meters. So newton meter is SI unit. So what is SI unit? SI unit of torque is, SI unit of torque is newton meter, NM, newton meter. Okay, so it is a vector quantity, it is a vector quantity. So its direction is, it is a vector quantity. Okay, so it is direction is perpendicular, it is direction is given by right hand rule, its direction is given by right hand rule, right hand rule. Okay, so this rule says that, what is this rule says that, you keep R bar, right hand on R bar, and it turns towards F bar, then this thumb indicates the direction of torque. It is along the axis. Okay, it is along the axis, perpendicular to the plane of rotation. So you keep R bar, F bar, if they lie in a plane, then this tau bar is perpendicular to the plane of rotation. So R bar, F bar lies in the XY plane, then the torque lies along Z direction. Okay, so it is given by a right hand rule. Okay, so this is the torque. What it causes? It causes rotation to the body. This torque produces rotation. It has another name, moment of force. It has another name, moment of force. Now, how to calculate this torque? I will give one example. Okay. Suppose this torque acts on a body. Example. A body is dropped from a point A. Find gravitational torque. Gravitational torque about the point O. Let it be origin. Okay. Suppose a body is dropped from a point A. Let it be, this is the point, dropped. Dropped means initial velocity 0. So what is the force acting on it? Mg. So we want a gravitational torque about this point O. Okay? Gravitational force. Exerted by this gravitational force, a body is dropped from a point A, so it will fall in a straight line, vertical line, because of gravitational force. So this force, we want a torque of this gravitational force. So this force into perpendicular distance, let it be R. So O2 distance is, let it be R. Okay, up to here, then the gravitational force is, torque is, tau is equal to force into perpendicular distance, Rf. That is, force is mg into R. Okay, this much of gravitational force acting on the object. Okay, Now, if this torque, if it's, this is called arm length. If this length is, torque depends on this torque. See, it is F R sine theta. So it depends on F R theta. It depends on these three factors. Okay. So it depends, torque depends on, depends on F R and theta. On these three factors it will depend. Force, it not only depends this arm length. Suppose the arm length is more, torque will be more. Okay. So suppose you want examples. Examples are, I will give few examples to understand this torque. So opening or closing a key. Opening or locking. Lock in a locking, opening, locking a key. So when key is open, you apply this torque. Because of that torque, it will rotate. Opening the door. Okay. Opening the door. Opening a door or window. So that window or door is hinges at a point. Opening or closing. Closing a door or window, you have to apply torque. Because of that torque, it will open. Because of that torque, it will, see, door will be like this. Suppose let it be a door. It will be hinges at these two points. So if you want to apply this door open, you have to apply, the handle will be here. Okay. Handle will be here. So you keep this door. Here it is fixed. So it will be rotates like this. So it will rotates like this, that door. Okay. So this is the door. So this door will open. Okay. So handle will be here. Handle will be here. So by taking that handle, you can open or close. So you are applying the force in this direction. Okay. That means this this is the perpendicular distance. This handle, not, it will not be here. If you keep here the door, it won't be open, because the R distance will becomes zero. Okay. Suppose that you are applying the force here, it won't be open. Whatever amount of force is applied, the torque will be zero. So if R is equal to zero, the torque will be become zero. That means this door will not open. That means it will not turn. Okay. So if R will be more, R will be more. That's why this handle will be keep away from the this fixed point. Okay. To make it a less force. So if R will be more, force will be less. Okay. And if the same force is applied here, okay, it will not open, because R is zero. So even though if a point of application of force passes through this fixed point, it won't open. So this point of application of force, if point of application of force, point of application of the force, point of application of force lies on the axis, or fixed point, then torque is equal to zero. Okay. So these are the few examples for torque. Now moment of this couple. What is a couple? Two equal, unlike, non-collinear forces constitutes a couple. Okay? Two equal, unlike, non-collinear forces constitutes a couple. That is the definition of couple. So, see this example. Suppose there is a uniform rod fixed at its center. So, this is a fixed point. Okay? This is a fixed point. Suppose two forces will act like this. One force is having the force like this, second force will be like this. So it is also having the same magnitude F. These two are equal forces, non-collinear, that means they are acting at different points, non-collinear and unlike, acts in opposite directions. Because of this two forces, it has a tendency to rotate. So it will rotate like this. So this is rotational. Okay? Now torque is equal to, what is the torque? Let it be, this is the point A, this is the O, this is the B. Okay? Now what is the net torque? Tau is equal to tau 1 plus tau 2. Net torque I want. Since these two are acts in the same direction, I have to add. Okay? Same sense, we have to add. If they are opposite sense, you subtract. Okay? Tau 1 is equal to force into perpendicular distance. So, F into OA plus F into OB, perpendicular distance. Okay? Then, you take F is common, OA plus OB. So, what is OA and OB? It will becomes AB. Okay? So, this makes a couple. So, we can call it as couple. Couple is equal to one of the magnitude of one of the forces. So, we can write it as couple. How we can define magnitude of one of the forces? And perpendicular distance, this is into perpendicular distance between them. Okay, thus we can define this couple. Couple is also having the same units as that of torque. So both this couple and torque causes rotation. So torque, couple, produce dash, rotation. Okay, to a body set into rotational motion by this torque or couple. Okay, so this torque and couple are essential for a body to set into rotational motion about an axis. Okay. So, this torque couple produces rotation about an axis. So, this is the definition of this couple. Now, here the next one is rotational equilibrium of a rigid body. We discussed already equilibrium concept. So a rotational equilibrium of a rigid body. A body rotational equilibrium, it has two. First one is it should be in translational equilibrium. Translational equilibrium. Rotational equilibrium. Rotational equilibrium. Okay. A body is in rotational equilibrium if it is in both translateral equilibrium and rotational equilibrium, then we can call it as it is in rotational equilibrium. Suppose the translational equilibrium, if all the forces, coplanar forces acting on a rigid body, coplanar forces, the summation of all the forces should be zero. So that is we can also call it as summation of, we can write it as translational equilibrium is sigma f should be zero. Summation of all the forces acting on the rigid body should be zero. These forces should be coplanar. All the forces should be coplanar forces. If they are coplanar forces, that means they lie in the same plane. Then the summation of all the forces acting on the rigid body is zero. So here summation means, or we can write sum of upward forces is equal to sum of downward forces. Okay, or sum of left hand forces should balance with the sum of right hand forces. Okay, so that is a translational equilibrium. Okay, sum of the upward forces should balance with the sum of the downward forces. This is also called law of parallel forces. Law of parallel forces. Law of parallel forces. And rotational equilibrium. Okay, this rotational equilibrium, a body, sigma, summation of all the torques should be zero. Summation of all the torques should be zero about a point. Okay, about a point. Summation of all the forces should be zero. Or sum of clockwise moments is equal to sum of anti-clockwise moments. Sum of clockwise moments is equal to sum of anti-clockwise moments. So, okay. So, this is called rotational condition for rotational equilibrium. Sum of clockwise moments should be equal to sum of anti-clockwise moments. Or summation of all the torques about its zero, then the body is said to be in rotational equilibrium. If it is in rotational equilibrium, it should satisfy both the conditions. Then that body is said to be in rotational equilibrium. Okay, it should satisfy both translational equilibrium and rotational equilibrium. Okay, I will explain with the help of a concept, with the help of a problem. Okay. Take this. Hi students, we are discussing the concept of torque. Okay, now you take a small problem based on that. Find the torque of the force. Find torque of the force. Of the force 7i cap plus 3j cap minus 5k cap, as shown in the figure. About origin, about or about the origin, about the origin, the force acts on the particle. The force acts on the particle, on the particle, on the particle whose position vector, whose position vector is given by, whose position vector is given by, given by I cap minus J cap plus K cap. So this is the problem. Okay, so find the torque of the force. Solution: what is given? Force is given. What is that? 7i cap plus 3j cap minus 5k cap. About origin, the force acting on the particle. So we want about origin torque. The position vector is given. So the force whose position vector is given and force acting on it. This is the point of application of force, where the force acts is called point of application of force. So the force will act like this on this particle whose position vector is r bar given. So position vector of the particle is given by I cap minus j cap plus k cap. Okay, we want to torque. Tau bar is given by r bar cross f bar. Okay, so that is r bar 7i cap plus 3j cap minus 5k cap cross f bar. So what is f bar? 7 r bar, this is r bar, I cap minus j cap minus j cap plus k cap. Okay, this is r bar cross f bar, 7i cap plus 3j cap minus 5k cap. Okay, this is tau bar. So to find this vector, it is better to use, I think you know how to find the cross product of two vectors, that I explained in vectors. So first you write I cap, J cap, K cap as the first row of the matrix. Second row is its components, R bar components, 1, minus 1, 1, and force components, 7, 3, minus 5. Okay, so that is how to find this. So this is the 3 by 3 matrix. First row you write as it is, I cap. You write this row and this column, you leave. So remaining elements are minus 1, 1, 3, minus 5. So you cross multiply, minus 1 into minus 5, 5, minus 3 into 1, 3. First you write it as plus, then minus. This row, this column, leave it. So what you will get? You will get this row and this column, you will get 1, 1, 7, 5. So 1 into minus 5, minus 5. 7 into 1, 7, minus 7. Plus k bar. This row and this column, leave it. 1 minus 1, 7, 3. Cross multiply. 1 into 3, 3, minus. Minus of minus becomes plus 7. So plus 7. Okay? So that is equal to 5 minus 3, 2 I cap. This is minus of minus plus 12 J cap. This is 10 K cap. Okay? This is the torque of this force. This is the answer. Okay? So I said this torque is also in vector quantity. Its direction is along the axis, perpendicular to plane of rotation, or we can say perpendicular to the plane containing R bar and F bar. So if you keep like this R bar and you turn, use right hand rule. This is the direction of R bar. You keep your right hand palm on R bar and turns towards F bar. Then this thumb gives the direction of tau bar, that is perpendicular to the plane of rotation about an axis. That's why it is also called axial vectors. Such vectors, its direction is along the axis. Such vectors are called axial vectors. Axial vectors. Okay. Vector is itself as a vector, but its orientation is along the axis. Okay. This is the determination of torque. You take another example. Okay. You take this example. A uniform rod. A uniform rod of 20 kg is hanging in horizontal position. With the help of two threads. It also supports a 40 kg mass as shown in the figure. Find the tension developed in each thread. So this is the problem. So diagram. This is the roof. Two threads are suspended with the help of through two threads, a rod. This is a rod. AB is suspended with the help of two threads, as shown in the figure. It also supports a 40 kg mass. So a load having 40 kg. This is a 40 kg. Okay. 40 kg thread. 40 kg load also supports from a distance L by 4. So this distance is L by 4, where L is length of the rod. Okay. So this is the problem. How we can solve? Okay. Solution. A uniform rod of mass 20 kg. So mass of the rod is 20 kg. Okay. So its length, let it be L. Okay. It supports 40 kg mass. So let it be capital M, load. 40 kg. This is a load. This is a scale, a rod. Rod mass. Okay. Now, find the tension in developed in each thread. We don't know the, we want a tension in the threads. We don't know. Let it be T1 and T2. So we want T1 and T2. So let T1 and T2 be the tension in the threads. Tensions in the two threads. Okay. We want T1 and T2. Okay. Since this rod is horizontal position, it is suspended. So it is under equilibrium. Okay. Because this rod is at rest. So it is under equilibrium. So since it rod is horizontal, we can apply law of parallel forces. So it, since it is in equilibrium, so from law of forces, so what we have, so translational equilibrium, first one is, so from translational equilibrium, what is translational equilibrium? Since the rod is horizontal, since the rod is horizontal, sigma F is equal to, translational equilibrium, sigma F is equal to 0. That is, summation of all these forces. What are the forces acting on the rod? Tensions T1 and T2. If you draw FBD of this rod, the forces acting on the rod are tension T1 and T2, which acts vertically up, and weight of the rod. Weight of the rod is Mg, acts vertically downwards. And this is load, capital Mg, acts vertically downwards. So this is the load weight. So all summation of all the forces is 0. That means, or we can write summation of upward forces is equal to downward forces. So summation of all the forces, T1 plus T2, we can write it as minus Mg minus capital Mg, because these two are in opposite directions. Okay. So there is no other forces acting on the rod. So it is 0. Summation of all the forces planar forces is 0. So T1 plus T2. So T1 plus T2 is equal to small m plus capital M of G. Okay, that is small m plus capital M is 40 plus 20, 60 G. So this is, you call it as equation 1. Since there are two unknowns, we need two mathematical equations to solve this problem. The first one is, from translational equilibrium we got this. Second one is, since the rod is, I will write here, since the rod is under equilibrium, it has in rotational equilibrium. So rotational equilibrium. So what is that rotational equilibrium? Summation of all the torques is 0. Summation of all the torques is 0 about a point. Okay. So first I will write about one end A. So I will write torques about one end A. So this is one end A. Now you write the torques. So see how I am writing. This end says the summation of all the torques means sum of clockwise torques is equal to clockwise torque is equal to sum of anti-clockwise torques. This is summation of all the torques is 0. So sum of all clockwise torques minus sum of anti-clockwise torques is 0. I will bring this plus and minus. I assumed anti-clockwise is positive or clockwise is positive and anti-clockwise is negative. That's your wish. But if you take one is positive, other should be, you take it as negative. Then it will, summation will becomes 0. So I will bring that side. You will get us sum of clockwise moments. So which one is a clockwise moment? Which one is a anti-clockwise moment? Listen carefully. Okay. You fix this point. Suppose you want torque of this. So you imagine only this force. This is fixed end. Then because of this force, the body will rotate like this. So it is anti-clockwise. Otherwise you fix like this, force will be like this. So it is anti-clockwise. So it is clockwise. Sorry, it is clockwise. So mg force is, what is the formula for torque? Force into perpendicular distance. Here force is mg into perpendicular distance. What is this perpendicular distance? L by 4. This is clockwise torque. And this one, about this point. Okay. So it is mg, it is also clockwise. Because of this force, the body turns like this. So force, torque is force into perpendicular distance. Force is mg, perpendicular distance. Weight of this rod acts from center. So this distance becomes L by 2. So torque is force into perpendicular distance, mg into L by 2. So plus mg into L by 2. So that is clockwise torques. There is no other clockwise torques. Anti-clockwise torques. Now see, torque of this force about this point. See, this point of application of this force is from here, fixed point. So here R becomes 0. So torque of this force about this point is 0. So what is other one? Other one is T2. So because of this force, the body rotates like this. Okay? So it is anti-clockwise. What is the value of torque? Force into perpendicular distance. Force is T2. Perpendicular distance is L. So that is T2 into L. Clear? How I am applying the torques? And L get cancelled. Okay? So what you will get? M, small m plus capital M. That is, this is 40 G by 4 plus this is 20 G by 2 is equal to T2. I cancel L. So I got T2 is equal to, so you will get 10 G plus 10 G. You will get 20 G. G take it as 10, you will get 200 Newtons. Okay? I substitute G is equal to 10. Then I got T2 is equal to 200 Newtons. So out of T1 and T2, I got T2. So T1 also. So you substitute here. Okay? I will write here. Okay? I am using this space. This is from equation 1. So from equation 1, what we have? T1 plus T2 is equal to 60G. G I take it as 10. So T1 is, I want T1 plus T2. T2 is 200, that is 600. So what is T1? 400 Newtons. Okay? So thus I got T1, T2 answers as 200 and 400 Newtons. Clear this sum? So here I am using the concept of torques and I am using the loss equilibrium concept. What is that equilibrium concept? When an object is in rotational equilibrium, it must be in translational equilibrium, that is sigma f is equal to 0, and it should be rotational equilibrium, sum of the torques about a point is 0. That is, sum of clockwise torques is equal to sum of anti-clockwise torques. When you are doing the problem, you can choose the fixed point from anywhere. Okay? So you can choose this point from one end. Here I am applying the torques about one end. You can apply torques about its center of gravity also. Okay? That I will show. See. I am applying second method. I am applying torques. I am writing torques about center of gravity. Center of gravity. I will write. Okay. Center of gravity I am writing. So what is the center of gravity, torques about of center of gravity? This torque is 0 because it is passing through center of gravity. So the torque produced because of this force is 0 because this force acts from center of gravity, fixed point. So this one is 0. Then remaining torques is this torque and this torque. So you fix this point. If you want this torque, it will be like this. So it is mg into this distance. So see, I am writing the torques about mg into perpendicular distance. What is this distance? This is L by 4, this is also L by 4. Because L by 4 plus L by 4 becomes L by 2. So this is L by 4. So this is clockwise torque. This is anti-clockwise torque. This torque is 0. And this one is, you check this one torque. It is also, this one is, this torque is, it is anti-clockwise. This torque is T2. T2 torque is, you fix this point. fix this point and turn this one. This one is also anti-clockwise. Okay, this one is anti-clockwise. This one is clockwise about this torque. No, this one is anti-clockwise. This one is also anti-clockwise. Okay, so sum of the anti-clockwise torques is equal to sum of the clockwise torques. So anti-clockwise, this one is also anti-clockwise. So T2 plus T2 into force into perpendicular distance. I am writing about center of gravity. So this is L by 2 into L by 2. So this is the sum of which is anti-clockwise. Sum of anti-clockwise moments is equal to, this is anti-clockwise moments. Anti-clockwise moments is equal to sum of clockwise moments. So this one is over, this one is over, this one is zero. Now we want this one. This is a clockwise torque. It is T1 into L by 2. So this is T1 into L by 2. So this is about torques about T1 and T2. So similarly, we can write torques about end B. I am writing end B. Okay. So end B. I am writing the torques. You listen carefully how I am writing the torques. This is about very important. Okay. Now, how we are getting this one? See, about end, this one is fixed. So the torque of T2 becomes zero about this point, because this force acts from center at this point, fixed point. So the torque of this T2 about this point is zero. Then torque of this is, you fix this one, because of this force the object moves like this. So it will become anti-clockwise. This one also becomes anti-clockwise. So sum of the anti-clockwise moments is equal to sum of the clockwise moments. So that is T1. So sum of clockwise moments is equal to, this one is clockwise moments. So sum of anti-clockwise moments are mg into L by 2, mg into L by 2 plus this one, capital mg into this distance from this end. So this one is L by 2 plus L by 2, L by 4. L by 2 plus L by 4, how much? L by 2 plus L by 4 becomes, 3 L by 4. Okay, so that is 3 capital MG into 3 L by 4 is equal to, this is anti-clockwise. Clockwise moment is this one about this point, force into perpendicular distance, T1 into L. So that is T1 into L. So this is another equation. So overall, I gave here 4 equations. You can use any 2 equations. You solve the problems. The first one equation is essential for us. And out of this equation, torques, I gave first equation, second equation, third equation. Out of these 3 equations, you can write any one. That is your wish. While you are applying the torques, you can choose a point of reference as your wish. You can take from this end, you can take that end, or you can take center of gravity. Okay. So, for example, suppose I take this one. Okay. I will got T1 directly. See, I will check T1, whether we are getting or not. So, T1 is equal to mg by 2. Mg is 20, g by 2, 10g, plus 40g, you will get 10g. So you will get 20g. That is 200. So T1 is equal to 200 newtons. As we got T2. T1 is 400 newtons. T2. T1. This is one of the torques. T1 is 400 newtons. Here T2. T2 you got is 200. Then you got T1 is 400. So one of the tensions, T1, we got it as 200 newtons. T1, we got it as 400 here. So this is, you'll get T1. This from this equation you got T2. So T2, T1. Here anti-clockwise moments. About this end, you will get T2. Some of the anti-clockwise tags, T into L. When you are writing thoughts about this one, T1. Okay. So we will get T1 is 200. T1 is 200 newtons. Okay. So you can change this one, either one. T1 is, here we got it as 400. Here we got mg is how much? Small m is 20. 20 by 2, 10. This one is 3. Here, see. Here you got 3. 3. 3 into then 30. So this capital Mg is 40. So 10 into 3, 30g. So this will become 40g. So it will become T1 is 40g. So you get 40 into G 10, that is 400. So we got T1 is 400 newtons. So we got this. Okay, like this, so like this also, we can do this sum. This is the second method. Clear? So here you have to learn how to apply the torques about a point. Clear? Next one. You take this sum. A 10 kg uniform rod, a 10 kg uniform rod OA is pivoted at O. Pivoted at O on a vertical wall with the help of a cable AB. Find the tension in the cable and reaction force applied by the pivot. Applied by the pivot. Okay. So this is the problem. Diagram is given. There is a vertical wall. So this is a vertical wall. A rod is pivoted at a point O. At a point O. So AB is a, OA is the rod. Okay, let it be OA. This rod is pivoted at one end of a vertical wall. Okay, so this is a vertical wall. Okay, this is a vertical wall with the help of a cable. So cable will be attached to it like this, one end. So AB is a cable. Okay, this cable makes 30 degrees with the rod. So this is a cable. So there will be a tension in the cable, let it be T. We want a tension in the cable because this rod weight has to supported by this pivoted end, reactional force of this pivot and this cable. Without this cable, this rod will falls like this. Okay, rod turns like this because this end is fixed. Now, so this is the problem. Okay, so how we can solve this one? Okay, a 10 kg uniform rod solution. Okay, mass of the rod is 10 kg. Okay. It is pivoted at end A. So let T be the tension in the cable. Okay. Let T be the tension in the cable. So we don't know, we have to find out this. Let R be the reaction. Reactional force. We want this reactional force applied by the pivot. So this is the point of pivotion. Okay, now this Rx, how it will act on the rod, we don't know this force, because weight of the rod acts vertically downwards, no doubt, because the rod is horizontal. So its weight of the rod acts vertically downwards. Even though it is not vertical, horizontal, this weight always acts vertically downwards because it is a gravitational force. Now the reactional force, how it will act on the rod, we don't know. So I divided this one into two components, Rx. This R is, I divide this R into two components. X component is Rx, Y component is Y. So this is X component, this is Y component. Okay, together makes this reactional force. So Rx I assumed like this, this one is the origin. So I take Rx is acts in this direction, Ry acts in this direction. Okay, I assumed this one is the origin. So R will act like this. Its direction we don't know. Okay, so I resolved this reactional force exerted by this pivot on the rod, we don't know, let it be R. Its direction as well as magnitude, we don't know. So magnitude, I assumed that R. So I assumed that it will act in this direction. Now it is resolved into components, two components, Rx and Ry. Rx is a horizontal component and Ry is a vertical component. Now, since this rod is under equilibrium, so I am using rotational equilibrium formulas. So since the rod is, so formula first one, since the rod is horizontal, we have sigma F is equal to 0. Summation of all the forces is 0. That is, or sum of the upward forces is equal to sum of downward forces. So if you draw FBD of this rod, downward force is mg, and upward forces, this tension is also resolved into components. Tension will act like this, and its vertical components will be like this. This is 30. This is 30. This one is T cos 30. Horizontal component, vertical component is T sin 30. So I resolved this tension also into components, vertical component and horizontal component. Now I am using this summation of all the forces on the rod is 0. So these forces acting on the rod is 0 because the rod is under equilibrium. Now summation of all the forces. So what are the all the forces? I will take this force Rx positive. So Rx is positive and minus t cos 30 acts in this direction, and is sigma fx is equal to 0. We can write this one is, we can write it as 0 sigma fx. So I am using, I resolved into components sigma fx is equal to 0. So I am writing this Rx t cos theta acts in this direction. So minus Rx minus t cos 30 is equal to 0. So there is no horizontal components. Okay, then we get Rx is equal to t cos 30. Cos 30 is cos 30 root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2 t. So you call it as equation 1, Rx. Similarly, Ry, y components I will write. Sigma Fy is equal to 0. Summation of all y components. This is y component, this is y component. Both are acts in the same direction. So you add Ry plus T sin 30 is equal to, these are the two upward forces. Downward forces is Mg. So that is equal to Mg. Or bring minus Mg is equal to 0. I will write this minus Mg this side, you will get plus Mg is equal to 0. So Ry, what is T sin 30? T by 2. Sin 30 is half M. What is mass of the rod? 10 kg. So 10 into 10, 10g. Okay. So equation 2. So Rx, Ry I got. And then you apply torque equations. Okay. Since the rod is horizontal, or to write the torque equations. So what is rotational equilibrium? This is rotational equilibrium. What is rotational equilibrium? Sigma tau is equal to 0. That is rotational equilibrium. Summation of all the torques acting on the rod about its center is 0. About a point is 0. So I am writing this. Okay, so otherwise sum of clockwise torques is equal to sum of the anti-clockwise torques. I am writing torque about pivot O is the point of pivotion. O is the point of pivotion. So the torque of R will becomes zero because the R passes through point of diversion. So the torque of R about the pivotion point is about O is zero. Its torque will be zero. Okay. Then torque about O R is zero. So what is the other forces acting on that? Okay. I will write here. So this I want a torque covers. What are the forces acting on that rod? Only three forces: R, Mg, and T. Torque of this R becomes zero. Torque of this Mg, force into perpendicular distance, that is L by 2. Force into perpendicular, Mg into L by 2, torque of this. This torque is, you fix this one, because of this force, the rod will rotate like this. So this will becomes clockwise. This will becomes clockwise torque. And torque of this, this one is force into perpendicular distance. So this force is into perpendicular distance. We want this distance. Okay. So this is L. This total is L. And we want this perpendicular. This is 30. So this is 90 degrees. From this triangle, I am using sine theta. Sine 30 is equal to this R by L. So R is equal to L sine 30. Okay. Sin 30 is half, so R is equal to L by 2. So I am using this expression, force into perpendicular distance. Okay, so this is the perpendicular distance, that is L by 2. So force into perpendicular distance, this will becomes anti-clockwise, this will becomes clockwise. So sum of the clockwise torques is equal to sum of anti-clockwise. Sum of clockwise torques is equal to sum of anti-clockwise torques. Okay. Sum of clockwise torques. Clockwise torques is what I said, this one is clockwise torque. Mg into L by 2, force into perpendicular distance is equal to sum of anti-clockwise torques. Sum of anti-clockwise torques. Force into perpendicular distance. T into R. R is L by 2. So this L by 2 get cancelled. So T is equal to Mg. Okay. What is M? M is 10 kg. So 10 into 10. 10 G. So T is equal to 10 into 10. 100 Newtons. Okay. So I got a tension in the cable as 100 Newtons. Then I want R value. Reactional force acting at a pivot also. Okay. So reactional force acting, I want Rx. I substitute T value here in equation 1, equation 2. So I will get Rx and Ry. Okay. So substitute T value in equation 1 and 2, we get R. Okay. So what is Rx? Rx is, I got it as 3 by 2 into t. That is 3 by 2 into 2 into t. T is 100. So that is 50 root 3. Okay, newtons. Next, Ry is equal to Ry plus T by 2. T by 2 is 50. Is equal to 100. So this is 100. So 50, Ry is equal to 50 newtons. So I got Rx and Ry. Then I want R. How do you calculate R? How do you get R? R is equal to Rx I cap plus Ry j cap. Mod of R is square root of Rx square plus Ry square. Square root of, what is Rx? 50 root 3 square. So 50 root 3 whole square plus, what is Ry? 50 square. So you take it as 50 square common, you will get 50 outside, root 3 square 3, 3 plus 1 becomes 4, root 4 becomes 2. So this is, R is also, you got it as 100 newtons. So you will get reactional force at the pivot is 100 newtons and tension in the cable is also 100 newtons. Okay, so this is the answer. Okay. You check this one. What is the answer? R is 100 and reactional in the cable. R is also 100. Okay? You take this. So this is the answer. You take this. These are the few examples regarding torques. Okay? I will explain some more examples. You do some more examples. Okay? Take this.